everybody does sell something. Whether it's a product or a service, a philosophy, an idea, most importantly, when you're selling yourself on a job interview or for a promotion, everybody sells something. I'm just like you, I'm not always fired up. You know, sometimes I want to go home early. So if I really, really want to go home early, especially on Friday afternoons, I'll tell myself, okay, Terri, there's no way you're going home unless you make 25 warm calls or cold calls. Now, if I really, really, really want to go home, I'll put 25 people on the list I'm fairly sure aren't going to be there. Do you know what I'm saying? Okay. He would rest his pen in his pen holder, which was his tie. And he would roll it up in his tie and roll it down. Roll it up in his tie and roll it down. Finally, we take the pen away. He had this little dip in his tie where he had been rolling it. And when we think of great presenters, we think of the legends. We think of Dr. Martin Luther King, JFK, even Ronald Reagan, considered the great communicator. Why? No handouts, no brochures, no PowerPoint. Just one human being speaking to the masses on what was considered some pretty unpopular material at times and moving them towards action.
In today's market, we are all looking for tools and skill set development to keep us at the top of our game. One of the most important traits of a solid professional is the ability to speak and present persuasively. Why? Because it's not just about getting out the information anymore. It's about generating results. Advancing these skills can help business professionals create new contacts, increase overall business opportunities, convert more prospects into clients, and complete more transactions. So when you're looking for a speaker for your next meeting, conference, or convention, consider a speaker that can both entertain and provide practical information that will help attendees become more polished and persuasive communicators. Terri Sjodin. Terri is a speaker you can count on to deliver a content-rich, high-energy program on communication, messaging, and persuasive presentation skills.
The number one biggest mistake that most professionals make when they're presenting is that their presentations have become far too informative in nature versus persuasive.
Terri balances the content of her material with energetic and entertaining anecdotes that bring the message to life.
As everybody started filing into the room, they took their seats, there were two big screens up, and then as everyone was seated, they dimmed the lights in the room. What happens to a room full of adults when you dim the lights in the room after lunch? Any idea? Absolutely. You see, we've been conditioned since we were in second and third grade that if somebody dims the lights in the room after lunch, it means it's nap time. Right, okay. So imagine there was all this fanfare, they dimmed the lights in the room, 22 minutes later, they flipped the lights on. It was as if they hit a room full of vampires at daybreak, okay? All these people kind of woke up from comas, and they're looking around, and they were like, what happened? And what's the first thing women notice about other women? Everything. Women are brutal. They're so brutal. They will absolutely critique and analyze another woman from head to toe. And unfortunately, even though they say women really should support women, women are usually like the first ones to attack other women. So the first thing is, can't we just all love each other? And then beyond that, the next thing is, well, what's the best rule of thumb? And the best rule of thumb is that conservative is best. Imagine this. You're in a courtroom. There's a judge at the back of the room. There's a jury off to the side. There's a prosecuting attorney, and there's a defense attorney. And when those two attorneys stand up to present their case, they begin with what? Opening arguments. Not opening features and benefits, opening arguments, right? And they say, ladies and gentlemen of the jury, over the next 2 or 3 days, we're going to prove the following. And they list right up front for the members of the jury what their most persuasive arguments are. Now they sit down, and the case opens. And at that point, they share their witnesses, their evidence, their testimonials, and their social proof. See, I'm not telling you to get rid of features and benefits. I'm not telling you to get rid of value adds. I'm not even telling you you can't use a consultative approach. All of those things have their appropriate time and space. But if you want to create influence, if you want to move people towards action, it's not about manipulation. It's about creating a logical, clean, persuasive case that moves people towards action. You see, the only way that you can win a debate round is if you identify right up front what your 9 or 10 most persuasive arguments are with that judge on that topic right now. And I thought, oh my gosh, I can't believe I haven't been doing this with my sales presentations. Because in a business environment, if you want to win, which is really the whole goal of delivering every presentation, then you've got to identify right up front what your 9 or 10 most persuasive arguments are with that client or prospect on that topic right now. And I went home and I revamped my entire presentation again, just like I would a debate case. And everything changed for me. The first thing that happened was I just felt so much more comfortable being persuasive versus being informative. See, I always had this resistance to selling because I always felt like it meant that I had to be hard sell or using crazy manipulative closing tactics. And by using debate strategy in a selling environment, it really made me feel so much more comfortable about being persuasive because it's just about building a logical, persuasive case with evidence to prove your point. That's the perspective, a debate in a business or selling environment. The second thing that happened for me was that it made my entire presentation shorter because debate really teaches you that you have to do everything in sound bites, sound bites, sound bites, sound bites. So it really requires you to communicate your message concisely in a shorter period of time. And the third thing that happened was I started having fun with it because, see, also in debate, you can't win just because you have great content. You also have to have great delivery. You have to have fun with it, and you have to be your authentic self.
Terri will help polish your team's overall delivery, presentation, and communication skills.
Your body naturally wants to gesture. Just to kind of prove my point, have you ever been on the phone, and your hands are gesturing away, but obviously no one can see you, right? We don't think to ourselves, I'm going to place my hand here and here and here. Your body just naturally does it. Well, the same thing happens when you're giving a presentation. Your body naturally wants to gesture, but sometimes men have a tendency to speak with their hands in their pockets. Now, you probably don't think that this is such a big deal, except that after a while, the energy's got to come out of somewhere, doesn't it? And they begin to do what we call the chicken, because their arms just kind of start flapping back and forth. Now, if their collar is a little tight or their shirt is a little tight, it will give you a complete rooster effect when you're watching the playback on the tape. Now, my absolute favorites are the gentlemen that play with their keys and fiddle with their change. And after a while, you start wondering just what the heck it is that they're doing down there.
Finally, Terri will show your team how to employ fresh creativity in their messaging and inspire them to get a little scrappy and earn the right to be heard.
My homework, and I walk into his office and he gives me one of these, oh my gosh, you know what, Ms. Sjodin, we are really pressed for time. We're going to have to do this in about 5 minutes. Has this ever happened to any of you? Sure. So I just took a deep breath and I said, so how was your weekend? And he goes, oh, it was fine, it was fine. It was very productive. I had a lot of things I had to do around the house. It wasn't too exciting. I said, gosh, you know, the same thing happened to me. I've been doing so much traveling. I haven't had any time at all to catch up on my laundry. I had this big pile of clothes. I just pulled it out of the dryer. I threw it on the living room floor. I figured I'd kick back, fold some clothes, and watch some TV. And I understand that you're really into bass fishing, so I made it a point to watch this show. I'm sure you've heard of it. It was called Bassmasters. And he was like his whole facial expressions changed. And he goes, you watched Bassmasters? And I said, yeah, I sure did. He goes, this last Sunday, you watched Bassmasters. I said, yes, sir, I sure did. He goes, it was a double Bassmasters weekend. I'm like, I know. I caught both episodes. Next thing I know, he starts telling me how it's his dream to someday go out fishing and be the guest fish guy with Jimmy Houston. And then he starts telling me how he got his BASS card. Next thing I know, he whips out his day tamer. He goes, young lady, have you ever been before? I said, no, sir, I haven't. He said, I am taking my family to an upcoming novice tournament. Would you like to join us? I'm all, woo, sign me up. Go. So finally say, gosh, Rick, you know, I know you're really pressed for time, but I do have some ideas on how I might be of service to your company. And he said, okay, darling, hold on a minute. And he got up and he closed the door. I went back to my original 30 minutes.
So when you're ready to hire a speaker who will help your team stay at the top of their game and become more polished and persuasive communicators, book Terri Sjodin. The Sjodin Communications team welcomes the opportunity to learn more about the meeting or event you're planning.
My goal is to literally give people tools that help them get to the next level, whatever that is. If it's building a different clientele base or augmenting their current business portfolio, whatever it is that they want to do, my question is, what is it you want to accomplish? Who do you want to speak to? How do I help you get there? And when you get there, if you have successful outcomes, then that's how we are evaluated. That's how Sjodin Communications is judged.